Hello dear students, so today is our first lab of textile printing. So in this video I will be sharing with you some view of the textile printing lab which you have in your college. So we will be going through various equipments we have in the class. So one by one we will be going through that. You are seeing here the water baths are there. This is called a water bath. And in this water bath we can have the dyeing process. These are temperature cold control devices. And this is a serological bath which you are seeing here. In these water bath or in the serological bath, what you are watching, there is a electrical immersion rod is present in the water bath. Okay, and you can connect it with the source of the light, source of power, and then you can control the temperatures. Okay, and you can control the temperature control switches are there, on off switches are there. And in the same way you have the deep dyeing, you can, there is a serological bath present in the textile printing lab also. So we have the controls of temperature control, time control, etc. And we have got a lid, stainless steel lid, and we got the deep bath in which we can dye any garment, I mean big piece of the cloth. So textile printing lab involves basically the dyeing operations and various other operations like printing, and some multiple subjects are also being taken up here in this lab, because a quite large lab you are watching. Area of this lab is quite much more than required for only one lab. So we have the view of your textile printing lab, and in which various equipments are there. So after these two water baths and serological bath, you have got one more color matching cabinets, as you can say, testing equipment and testing for the light. We have got the on off switches on this color matching cabinet, with the on off switch, and then artificial daylight, ADL D65, and then we have the fluorescent LED light, and then we have the filament light, means bulb light. You have got a bulb light, it's a fluorescent light, and then it is the UV light. When we connect, this is a color matching cabinet. Okay, color matching cabinet. This is basically used for the purpose of, you can say, matching of shades when we put the shade in the different light sources. So we get different tones of the color. After this, this is a, you can say, a transfer printing press is there. This is particularly, you can say, used for the purpose of transfer printing. This is one technique of the printing we will be discussing in the methods of printing later on. So in this technique of printing, we are basically printing the dispersed dyes on the synthetic fabrics. Okay, so this is basically a transfer of the dye, which is based on the sublimation property. Directly the dye transfers to the fabric. Okay, so there is a press, it is called a transfer printing press. We have got a mounted piece of, you can say, press, and this is the time control. Timer is there, and here we put the fabric, and the here we put the fabric and the print we want to make. Okay, so we can also, we can lift this press and then put it down in this way, and then we give the time of heating by which the print gets transferred onto the fabric. Okay, so after this, what next is the, you can say here at the right of me is the block printing table. It's a flat surface table which is you can say laid with this cloth of carpet, which is a little bit resilient, and on this table we set the fabric, okay, and by this we print the blocks, okay. So block printing is done on this table. This is called a block printing table. So today through this video I will be you can say introducing you the various equipments which are present and the in the lab, okay. So next is your, this is a screen printing table. It's a very special table, you can say commercial table is there, we can call it as a commercial table. So what we are seeing here is a, is also one of the techniques we'll be discussing in detail regarding when we discuss about the various equipments of the printing table, of the screen printing of course, and then I will tell you about the various parts of this table and what is the purpose of those parts. Today it's just an introductory video, and so I am acquainting you with the various, the refrigerator is there, whenever we are dyeing some naphthol dyes, okay, so we use this refrigerator for, you can say, naphthalation and diazotization of the bases, and then there is of course this drying oven is there, and in the drying oven, in the drying oven what we are doing is drying the samples, we are putting the printed samples, dyed samples, okay. So this is drying oven, we can set the temperature, okay, the controls are there on the monitor, okay. So again we have one water bath is there, and this is one of the machines which we use for the purpose of dyeing. This is called rota dyer, okay. Rota dyer means we are putting various samples in the beakers, and then we are setting those beakers in the this inside of the machine you are seeing, we are setting those beakers in the in this frame we set the beakers, and stainless steel beakers are there, and we rotate this. On this we have various controls are there, like main control is there, timer is there, and motor on, heater is on, okay, and then we have the, of course, timer control is there, time we can set by this, and here we can control the temperature. So this is a rota dyer machine used for multiple sample dyeings in the lab. So alongside that we have got different cases for different equipments, and here we have got lists are displayed in the labs for the various practicals. This is the, you can say, dyes and chemicals which are used for the dyeing and the printing. Various chemicals are present here as we can see from the close-ups. So all these chemicals which we use in the, you can say, sodium hydroxide is there, potassium carbonate is there. So all these chemicals are, sodium hydrosulfide is there, okay. So all this is a urea. So all these chemicals are used in various dyes base. These are the various dyes we are seeing, the basic dyes, reactive dyes, and various chemicals of course. So these are the two you can say shelves are there for the chemicals, okay. So again, when we have one machine in the this lab, this is called a continuous padding mangle and stentor machine. which is normally used for the purpose of, you can say, padding practicals and for stenting, means drying, and you can say drying chamber is there, setting chamber is there, drying chamber, basically it is used as a drying chamber. So you got this bath is there, this is a trough, this is a compressor for the hydraulic, you can see pneumatic movement of this. These are pneumatic cylinders we are seeing. These are controlled by the air pressure. There is a tubing provided for the, this blue color tubing you are seeing, this controls the air pressure. Okay, so in this, here we take the solution and then we pass through it, and then there are the rollers. Three bowl padding mangle is there, stainless steel roller is there in the center, and then this in synchronization, it passes through the this machine, and then this, through this guide rollers, these are the stainless steel guide rollers, and through this guide roller, this sample is mounted in this machine. The one frame is inside the machine, so that we take out and set the sample, printed sample on this, and through this chamber sample goes out and we get the dried or the cured sample, particularly for the purpose of, you can say, pigment printed samples. We particularly use this machine. So I'll show you inside. There is a sample mounting device is there. It's not coming out. Of course, I'll set it. Someday else I'll show it to you. What is this sample mounting machine? So this is the drying and curing chamber we are seeing. This is a multi-purpose bench where students can sit down and note down something in the classes, and we have got also installed this screens for the purpose of lectures. So this is just an introduction to the various equipments required for the textile printing. And in the next lecture, I will be showing the various types of methods, means block, screen, and I will show you the required equipments for that purpose. Okay, so for today's lecture, it is enough. You got to get introduced with the various equipments in the lab and where we can perform the practical. We got a 5 meter long, you can say, printing table is there, and where many groups of people can perform various practicals of printing and doing some good jobs at the in the printing lab. So for today's it's enough. Thank you very much.